Well, good morning, everyone, and thanks for joining us here for the begin, as we begin the construction process for the University District Gateway Bridge. This is a project that will change the landscape of the east part of downtown Spokane. The iconic structure will enhance Spokane's skyline and establish new connections between higher education and business and the healthcare in a pedestrian-friendly way and access across this area of Spokane. We're standing on the north landing for the bridge, which is the gateway to connecting students, research, and development to commerce and residential neighborhoods to the south. Today, we're joined by several partners who have been instrumental in getting us to this point. Chancellor Lisa Brown will talk about WSU's Spokane partnership in the project and the importance of this bridge. Several members of our state legislature delegation are with us and who truly helped us secure $8.8 million in the state transportation funding for Spokane through the Connecting Washington bill last year. Senator Andy Billig and Michael Baumgartner will also joined by Representative Marcus Riccelli here at the podium in a moment. Joining us today, as you can see, is Council President Ben Stuckert, Councilman Brian Biggs, and Candace Mum. And Shani Marchand was also the bridge artist, is joining us today. Thank you for joining us all. University District Board Chair Carl Otterstrom, will discuss the significance of the bridge with the University District mission and the higher education and technology transfer. Councilwoman Amber Waldrop, who chairs the city's Public Works Committee, has played a critical part in helping to define and execute the vision for connecting the University District to the East Spokane Business District. Today, we are announcing a construction schedule for the University District Gateway Bridge that begins with a request for bids in the next couple of weeks. Construction of the bridge will begin next year and is expected to be completed in 2018. The University District Gateway Bridge is a perfect next step in the execution of the 2004 strategic master plan called by the University District. And I quote, "A bold vision and plan to attract a critical mass of top students, staff, and faculty, cutting-edge research, and creative entrepreneurs, all of which are the catalyst for increased commercialization of technology, increased technology, growth in our healthcare industry, and overall economic prosperity for the region." Who would have ever guessed everything that's been happening over the last couple years when that quote was done? Over the past dozen years, the presence of WSU Spokane, Eastern Washington University, Whitworth University, Gonzaga University, the University of Washington, and our community colleges of Spokane have galvanized the momentum and the energy that has opened up new ideas and even greater possibilities. Today, the University District is a confluence of innovation, discovery, entrepreneurship, scholarship, and the neighborhood development. It is a thriving area that the City Council and I have targeted for catalytic infrastructure investments to grow employment and investment in our area, and especially in the East Sprague Business District. Etails, a homegrown e-commerce and marketing company that traces its roots to Gonzaga University's Hogan Entrepreneurial Business Plan Competition, is the University District's most recent success story that many of us have been reading about just over the last weekend. Of course, a New York company announced last week that it purchased Etails for $75 million and plans to keep the company headquarters right here in the University District. Last month, a collection of founding partners launched Urbanova, Spokane's Smart City Initiative out of the University District, as a living laboratory where researchers, entrepreneurs, and citizens can test smart technology in city applications. These are the kinds of success stories that are planned and envisioned as we continue this great investment in our community. The first steps in the request for bids, which will go out in mid-November, will with the plan to hire a contractor over the winter. Earth will begin to move by the end of the first quarter and start the process of lifting the bridge. This is possible because of collaboration and partnership to build sustainable strength in our higher education, medical technology, and biotechnology industries. WSU Spokane will take on the responsibility of maintaining the bridge once it is built, and the University District continues to be a great partner in executing the vision. With that, I'd like to invite WSU Spokane Chancellor Lisa Brown to the podium to talk about the university's partnership with this vision.
Thank thank you, Mayor, and everyone here this morning. This is a beautiful day that many of us have been waiting for a long time. And I just am here to welcome you to the campus and to the heart of the University District. I see partners in higher education here today as well. I'm a fellow chancellor from the community colleges, University of Washington and Eastern, I see in the crowd. I'm sure there are others representing all the universities in the district. How about a shout out for football over the weekend? That was pretty good for several teams. So I'm just going to say thank you and welcome. This has been a big week for us. 1 week ago today, we were having the grand opening of the clinic right over here, serving patients and practicing interprofessional team-based care. Just last week, we also heard about accreditation of the WSU Medical School. So we've jumped that hurdle and we'll start recruiting and accepting students soon for the first class that will start in fall 2017. And all of the education and research and the economic development that the mayor referred to would not be possible without the partnerships that you're going to hear about, without the public and private investments that you're also going to hear about, and without leaders from business, education, and the public sector at all levels, federal, state, county, and city, and beyond, being willing to step forward and make some tough decisions and take some tough votes. So my special thanks, having been in their shoes, goes out to our next group of speakers who did take some tough votes and made some tough decisions, but ones that will prioritize our community, our commitment to our neighborhoods and to urban Spokane, and to our future education potential of our students and families. Education transforms individuals' lives. As a first-generation college student, I can attest to that. It transforms families' opportunities, and it transforms communities, and that's what we're all about today. So thank you for being here.
Well, thank you very much, Chancellor. It has been an awesome week for WSU and to so many of our partners here. Several members of our state legislature are with us, and at this time I'd like to invite Senator Billig and then Senator Baumgartner and Representative Marcus Riccelli.
Great. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you to everybody that is here today, and thank you to everybody that helped make this day a reality. You know, this bridge is important for so many reasons, and when I think about this bridge, I always think back to the story 5 years ago. 5 years ago, we were working on a very big capital budget ask, and that was to build what we at that time called the medical school building. It's got a fancier name than that, but it actually is going to be a medical school building. And I think it was $63 million that we got in the capital budget 5 years ago for that. And it was kind of the talk of the community. We came back from that legislative session. A lot of people were talking to us about it. And I had somebody come up to me at an event. It was actually at my daughter's school, and he had a child at the school as well. And he is a researcher at WSU Spokane. And he came up to me and he said, "I just want to thank you so much for your work on the capital budget." And of course, assuming he's talking about the $63 million building, and I said, "Yeah, it's a really important building, and we're going to grow medical education here." And he goes, "No, I'm not talking about the building. I'm talking about the $200,000 that you got for the pre-planning for the bridge, the bike and pedestrian bridge." He said, "I like to walk to work, but I don't have a safe way to do it, so I often don't." And I thought, okay, we might be onto something here. I wish it hadn't taken another 5 years to actually get the full funding for it, but we did. And this bridge, it's important for so many reasons. It's important for safety, for health, and for economic development. And safety, as that story conveys, the people that walk and bike to work should have a safe corridor to do that in, to connect where they work and study to where they live. It's important for health because we need to make the healthy transportation choices the easy transportation choices, and we do that with this bridge. And it's important for economic development because this bridge is going to spur development on both sides of the railroad tracks, and that benefits everyone in our community. So, you know, this bridge represents your tax and fee dollars at work. It's part of the transportation infrastructure package, as the mayor mentioned. And it was the result of so much groundwork in the community by many of you and others in the community, and also work in the legislature. And I just very much appreciate the bipartisan partnership of the legislature. Representative Richelli, Representative Ormsby, and Senator Baumgartner all working together to vote for the transportation infrastructure package that's going to help make this bridge a reality. So thank you so much. I appreciate being here to celebrate with you and look forward to being here for the ribbon cutting in a couple more years. Thank you.
Well, good morning, everybody. I'm Senator Mike Baumgartner. Thank you for allowing me to be here with you on this great day. You know, we've been hitting some real grand slams for Spokane in the state legislature. Two medical schools, full funding for a north-south freeway, this tremendous transportation package, and it's really a testament to the community support and great bipartisanship. People working together, Republicans, Democrats working together at the local level, the community level, and at the state level. And so it's just really fun to be here to celebrate. You know, you get to really like these groundbreakings, whether it's the new teaching clinic or what we were doing up on the North South Freeway last week or this project. Certainly want to echo the comments of gratitude towards my third district colleagues. Really the credit for this bridge in the state legislature really goes to Senator Billig, Representative Richelli, and Representative Ormsby. When the transportation package came out of the Senate, we didn't actually have the money for this project. We were working on the freeway and some of the other projects, and it really was those guys in the 3rd District that in negotiations put that in, so real credit to them. I'm also really pleased to see us doing this project now. You know, when the city was coming back and asking, as people always do this time of year, for more money in the next legislative session, we said, hey, how about that bridge? How's that going? Let's talk about that. So it was good to see the city and WSU come to agreement on a few things and get this project started in terms of timing. And I'm also hoping, looking forward to what it's going to do to this area. You know, as somebody that studied economic competitiveness and innovation, you know, this is really has been the missing piece, I think, to Spokane's innovation economy, this hub of knowledge that we're developing here. So this is just so exciting. And then finally, I'll just say, I'm really looking forward to this being done. So I can ride my kids down here all together on the same bike. As many of you know, I have 4 kids that are 5 and under, and I figure out a way to get one on the front, one on the back, and then I have a trailer. But they're getting bigger, but I'm going to ride all 4 of them over that bike path, and so up over that bridge and down here. So we got to get that thing done. Anyhow, thanks for allowing me to be here today, and this really is just a tremendous accomplishment for our community, and looking forward to getting this thing done. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. My name is State Representative Marcus Richelli. I'm pleased to be joining you today, and go off script for a second. Just say, I don't think this is going to be the landing. This is the takeoff point. Looking behind you all and in front of me, we've had over $200 million of state capital investment in this community. So there is a lot of excitement. So together, as has been mentioned, we worked to secure a multimodal package. Transportation revenue package is going to bring over $1 billion to our community. And I want to echo again, because isn't it fun? I'm gonna say it, out of a couple weeks outside of an election, isn't it fun when we work together and get stuff done in this community? So we're this Washington and not that other Washington. And it's worth repeating again, thanks to Senator Billig, Representative Ormsby, and to my friend on the other side of the aisle, but not on the other side of many of our things that we're doing to move our community forward, Senator Baumgartner. So thank you truly, Senator Baumgartner, for taking a tough vote. These investments will improve safety, reduce congestion, and create jobs while promoting livable communities. The University District Gateway Bridge will have tangible impact on mobility and economic development. Just last week, I was at the East Sprague Business Association event with over 200 citizens, and they're very excited about what this means to their area. And on the north side, again, it's just another building block to continual investment. As vice chair of the healthcare committee, I'd be remiss if I didn't also highlight the importance of this connection as we encourage more people to take part in healthy activities. We face an obesity and diabetes epidemic. This bridge will get folks walking, running, biking, and we're gonna try and beat back that obesity epidemic and diabetes epidemic. Today we celebrate a bridge to economic development and revitalization, a bridge to even more vibrant River Point campus, and a bridge to healthier and more livable community. So congrats to all involved. Thank you.
Again, as you can see, the collaboration amongst your city government and our state legislature is very strong, both between levels of government and between our political parties. And then thank you to all your leadership. As I often say, it was the one time that I've testified, but in many of the issues the same, with Mayor Murray from Seattle. We actually testified in front of the Senate Transportation Committee on this issue. I do just for a moment. I remember then the chair of that was said to us, Senator Curtis King. We both sat down at the same time, and Mayor Murray said, "Well, I'll let my friend from the east side of the state go first." And the senators reminded former Senator Murray that he was the chair of the committee, and that Mayor Murray should go first. He had 3 minutes. And the mayor from Spokane had as much time as he wanted. If you don't know, Curtis King is from the east side of the state. So that was as I stayed to my 3 minutes. But we testified together in a very difficult, like I said, for the legislature, difficult vote, something that had been in the works for some years. But definitely it was their leadership that brought us here today. It is a major investment, not only by our community, but definitely by the state. So with that, I'd also like to invite, who has been behind a lot of this work for some time now, the University District that had this vision a couple decades ago and now serving as the chair of that board, Carl Arterstrom.
Well, good morning, and thank you for this opportunity to represent the University District Development Association. Even though Spokane was built around a river, it has direct access to neither navigable rivers nor ocean ports. However, the transportation infrastructure originally provided by the railroads formed the stitching that traversed mountains, bridged political boundaries and cultural divisions, and in concert with natural resources and human toil, allowed the city to become the heart of the Inland Empire. While much has changed in the 135 years since the Northern Pacific reached Spokane, and actually right here was one of their rail yards, we find ourselves in a similar juxtaposition. River and rail, the bridging of opportunities. The University District Gateway Bridge and function will not only transcend the barriers imposed by our past, it offers vistas of what our city is and is becoming. It will connect the natural assets of the Spokane River with the innovation of place and human creativity here in the U District. The pedestrian and bicycle connections across the bridge will coordinate with mass transit connections, stitching together health sciences, research, and academics on the north to the health services and the community to the south. On behalf of the University District Development Association, including its university community and business members, I want to thank the visionaries who saw something more than the barriers of the past. I thank community leader Dave Clack, and among others, for creating and maintaining a vision for the district and in particular for the future Gateway Bridge. I thank legislators who created funding tools that enabled the university district and the city to provide critical leverage to move the project forward into design and property acquisition. And I thank the current legislators, including Senators Billig and Baumgartner and Representative Vercelli, as well as Representative Ormsby, who came together in a bipartisan fashion to fund Connecting Washington, the largest transportation funding bill in the state's history. The University District Development Association will continue to partner with the City of Spokane, property owners, developers, and institutional partners in enriching the tapestry of our beautiful city and implementing the vision for Spokane's University District. The University District looks forward to the grand opening of this important gateway to opportunity in 2018. Thank you.
Thank you, Carl, and all those that are here that I see that serve on the University District Board over the years. Thank you for really shepherding these growth opportunities for us. Finally, today, it gives me great pleasure to invite Councilwoman Amber Waldrop to the podium. She has been very passionate behind these investments, and also this year is leading our legislative agenda building process. Legislators? Since we've been so good at bridges, we thought we'd bridge some more. So with that, bridging us to the future, I'd like to ask Councilwoman Waldrop to come to the podium.
Well, good morning. Just like everyone else who's spoken this morning, I'm very excited very passionate about this project and grateful to be here. And I just want to thank the state legislators so much for their work in helping make this a reality. Thank you very much. I also see a lot of staff from the city in the audience, as well as my fellow council members. We've had many past council members, past mayors, current mayor, who've been very supportive and visionary about this project. And it's exciting to be here to see this come to reality. So I'll ask a question. How will we measure the success of this coming bridge? Connecting the U District north to south will create a pathway to prosperity for many in our community. We've heard today about the tremendous future in medical education, entrepreneurship, scientific research that will feed a new economic awakening here in Spokane. But the success of the bridge should also be measured by how it will support opportunities and prosperity for small businesses and the residents of this area. And as Representative Richelli noted, last week we had a great dinner. The East Spokane Business Association hosted many of us to celebrate all the investment that's happening in this area. And that dinner is representative of the community coming together for a common goal of economic growth and health that benefits all of us. Because of this strong spirit here in this area, the city has targeted the East Sprague area for significant public investments to help drive construction of new housing, new private commercial development, and job creation. We are extending Martin Luther King Jr. Way. We're building out the Ben Burr Trail. We're putting in wastewater tanks that will allow for something to be built on top, some public amenities. And this spring, we'll break ground on a major streetscape and reconstruction project between Helena and Stone on East Sprague. And this project is designed to enhance the pedestrian experience, to reduce crime, and create a sense of place. And in the next several years, this placemaking work and infrastructure improvement will come further west along East Sprague, supporting new investment at the south end of the bridge. So success of the bridge will be measured by the number of new businesses, the growth of current businesses, and the mixture of economic activity on both sides of the bridge. The success of the bridge will also be measured by the opportunities it opens up for my friends and neighbors who live in this neighborhood to the north and to the south, many of whom are struggling to make ends meet. My hope is that this soon-to-be-completed Gateway Bridge will be a bridge to prosperity for them, that it will connect these neighbors to good-paying jobs, to services, to educational opportunities, and to better health. And I challenge all of us to measure the success of the bridge, not just by the number of PhDs or MDs that will walk over it, but by the number of first-in-family college graduates and the number of people from the neighborhood who are hired into good-paying jobs who will cross over it. So the vision of a more connected and economically sustainable future is becoming a reality here in the University District and for the entire city of Spokane because of the collaboration, the intention, and the investment that we celebrate today. And I look forward to returning to see the ribbon cut on this Gateway Bridge and to a more healthier and more prosperous future for everyone who will cross over it. Thank you.
Well, that does it for us today. I do have to say, and as the councilwoman said, it is the University District, it is the citizens, it is the neighborhoods that really carried this vision over many different administrations. Actually, my first ribbon cutting was right over here, and I actually didn't do it. Mary Verner came back to do that because it was her vision and support of the community that really started the Martin Luther King Way. And we do hope to bring back those that have been a part of this over the years as we seem that we will do the ribbon cutting on this come in the coming year. And thank you to the state legislators, thank you to our city council members, and most of all, thank you to all of those that are here with us today that have been a part of this. I do want to thank the city staff that has been a part of this, in particular Catherine Miller, who often is the one behind much of the work that gets done for those of us that are lobbying and really advocating for these projects. I wanted to thank her for her work on this. There was many a day that I said, well, in the next couple hours, I need to make a phone call to a senator or representative. Could you get me a few things? And I don't know whether she always knew why I was asking it, but I hope today is a commitment, again, to our staff that have made this possible. Thank you again for being here with us today, and we look forward to opening this in the year to come. With that, we can take any questions if there are any. If not, I know that those that are up here with me at the podium are more than happy to take any interviews. Thank you.